All of the fossil fuels that we're burning put out little molecules of carbon dioxide. These molecules stay in the atmosphere. Think of all the oil, all the gas, all of the coal, all of the fossil fuels we've burnt for hundreds of years. All of that weight is going into the atmosphere. It stays anywhere from 100 to 1,000 years. Who cares? We all do. Each of these little molecules of CO2 act like a feather in a feather bed. If you have a cold night and a thin blanket and you're shivering, you go get a cover and it's full of feathers and you put it on there, and 5 minutes you're just cozy. That's exactly what the atmosphere does. The CO2 molecules act like feathers in a feather bed. You double the number of CO2 molecules, you double the feathers. Where's the heat going? It's gonna stay there. We take measurements and around the world and areas where they're not affected by local pollution. Because if we take a sample like here in Boulder, all of the cars, the power plants, put a signal in there that we find that's probably not accurate. But if we go to a tall mountain that's away from any sources, now we have a sample that measures a broad area. So we try to measure in remote areas, on top of mountains in the middle of Pacific. Mauna Loa, Hawaii is a good illustration. South Pole, you can't get any farther away. And like say in Mongolia, we have a retired teacher there who doesn't speak English, and for years and years and years, every week she puts a backpack on with a sampling system, walks 3 or 4 kilometers up to the top of a mountain. There's no fires around, she doesn't have electricity at her house, and she fills 2 bottles of air, very clean. And these bottles then are taken down. She gets on a train 12 hours to Ulaanbaatar, puts them in the embassy, and eventually a week or two later we get these. The same thing is happening at 75 locations around the world. Mount Kenya, little islands in the Pacific, mountains in Europe, up in the Arctic. There's dedicated people filling bottles of air. It takes a whole week to learn how to fill a bottle of air without contaminating. Because if you even take a breath nearby, measurement screwed. If you've had a lunch and you burp a little methane, screwed measurement. We have about 20,000 of these bottles moving around and samples any time of the year. And they're going into the mail, they're coming back. Some are going in camels, some are going in Mercedes-Benz.